Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the next to last race for Daytona Speedweeks as we come close to completion here at Daytona under the bright clear, crisp sky. The sky's blue, not even a single cloud in the sky. The sun's out. It's very hot out here at Daytona Beach, Florida, as the NASCAR Xfinity Series roll off, as they'll roll off this season at Daytona for the PowerShares 300 QQQ at Daytona. Kyle Busch is moving over to the 54 Monster Energy car for this race. He had a terrible start in Sprint Cup Series and the Sprint Unlimited and the Can-Am Duel. And sadly, he will not make it into the Daytona 500. What a season 2 Sprint Cup champion is not off to a good start. However, he did get a chance to redeem himself when he won, when he came in the top 5, when he came in the top 10 at Daytona for the Truck Series. And guys, this is NASCAR Fan 88's 5th or 6th pole of his racing career, and his first ever start in the Xfinity Series. He got a 2nd place finish in the Truck Series. Can he try to come in 1st this time in the Xfinity Series? We'll have to find out. Also, it's also shocking that Blake Koch and Ty Dillon will drive the 8 and 3 DEI race cars that Dale Earnhardt Jr. drove in 2007 in the NASCAR games. And he did drove this at Kansas 2007 in the Diecast Racing Series. And Ty Dillon pilots the number 3 Dale Earnhardt Hall of Fame tribute car. This car is just special memories about the 7-time Cup champion, Dale Earnhardt Sr. The legacy continues. Also, what's also shocking, the 2 Bushes, James and Chris, they were to start alongside for today. Chris Busch is in the 21 Wood Brothers for the Xfinity Series. James Busch won him in the Xfinity Series in 2012 at Daytona. And Michael Waltrip in the 99 car, he won here at Daytona 3 times. One in the Daytona 500 in 2001, one in Pepsi 400 in 2002, and one in 2003 in the Daytona 500, and one in the 2011 truck race. With all the pre-race news out of the way, let's get you down trackside with the most famous words in motorsports. When we come back, we'll show you the starting lineup for the PowerShares 300 QQQ when we return after these messages. I'm Dale, Junior Fan of the Broadcast Booth, giving you today's broadcast of the NASCAR Xfinity Series race here at Daytona for the PowerShares 300 QQQ at Daytona for the first Xfinity race of Season 4. We'll be right back in just a moment.
I guess I'll take it from here. Just don't leak any fluid on me.
The inside of a race car can feel as hot as the Sahara. How does Dale Jr. overcome it? Energy, focus, control. Yourself.
I got some breath mints if you want.
The oil is for y'all.
Jimmy Jones.
segítséget is kérek, és kérem, siessenek!
Jó estét, örömmel Jimmy Jones-tól?
Ez gyorsan ment.
Jimmy Jones, the world's greatest sandwich delivery.
Welcome back to the PowerShares QQQ 300 here at Daytona for the NASCAR Xfinity Series race 1 for the NASCAR Xfinity Series. The first race of the NASCAR Xfinity Series. Whoever wins this race will advance of the NASCAR Xfinity Series chase for the championship. And whoever has the most top 10s and whoever has the most top 10s coming to the first switching race, that driver will be awarded with $100,000 when it's over with the most top 10s for the NASCAR Xfinity Series. Also, the NASCAR Xfinity Series will make the All-Star race at Iowa Speedway. Stay tuned for that. With the pre-race news out of the way, let's take a look at the starting lineup presented by Monster Energy Drink. Row 1, NASCAR Fan 88 and Kyle Busch. NASCAR Fan 88 is the pole sitter. Row 2, Chase Elliott and Blake Koch. Row 3, Ty Dillon and Justin Allgaier. Row 4, Kevin Harvick and Dale Earnhardt Jr. Row 5, James and Chris Buescher. Row 6, Regan Smith and Minion Fan 1024. Row 7, Dale Wallace Jr. and Joey Logano. Row 8, David Starr and Casey Kane. Row 9, Ryan Reed and Brendan Pohl. And row 10, rounding out the field, the number 99 UPS Ford of Michael Waltrip. Green flag's out. The PowerShares 300 Triple Q is underway for the NASCAR Xfinity Series. Dale Jr. leads lap 1. Here comes Chris Buescher and Joe Logano to join the party. And so is Brendan Pohl, who started for a run at the back. And so is Minion Fan. He is going to lead this lap. From push from Chase Elliott. Chase Elliott is going to knock Minion Fan out of the way. And Chase Elliott will lead in the lap as he knocks Brendan Pohl out of the way. Gets a push from Michael Waltrip. White flag is out as Brendan Pohl makes contact from Minion Fan. Gets in the wall. Checker flag. Justin Allgaier wins at Daytona. Congratulations to Justin Allgaier as we go through another race with no cautions or wrecks. Well, Brendan Pohl hit the wall in turn 1, so that counts a little bit. But let's see the replay. You just cannot script this Xfinity Series race. By far, one of the best and probably by far one of the best Xfinity Series diecast races we have ever seen, and it comes in the season opener of the Xfinity Series. And Brendan and Pohl started from the back and moved all the way up to the front in just two laps. And Brendan Pohl gives Joey Logano a little bump, and that would be the bump and run. And 3x3 with Brendan Pohl, Joey Logano, and Chris Buescher. Here comes Minion Fan 1024 to make it 4 wide to the inside from push from Chase Elliott. He leads the lap. Comes outside to blind.